Ladies and gentlemen, welcome, welcome, welcome to the film review show that desperately wants to find a genie in a lamp. In the meantime, I've had to make do with a thrills and spills action movie starring the bloke that played the young Darth Vader. Keep your wits about you, folks. It's Jumper. So, what's the plot? Well, after falling into a frozen river as a child, Hayden Christianson's David finds that he has the ability to teleport himself, or in the parlance of this movie, jump. Deciding to use his gift for material benefit, David spends his early adult life robbing banks and generally having a ball. But the good times come to an end when he realizes that a group of religious fanatics are after him. Mortimer, roll the tape.
Come on. All good, see?
Great, come back.
David!
Millie, don't go out there!
In the same way that light follows day or Costello follows Elvis, you can bet your bottom dollar that Hollywood will try and up the stakes in the world of high-concept movies. Over the last few years, we've had X-Men, Spidermen, Supermen, Super Ex-Girlfriends, Four Fantastic Men, Super Dogs, Extraordinary Gentlemen, Hunks, Hellboys, Incredibles, and Batman. Hopping onto the big-budget high-concept bandwagon is the concept of jumping. The jumper is able to travel through wormholes from point A to point B, as long as they have visited that location before. It works a little bit like this. Now, I did say a little bit like this because the special effects are, well, a touch better. Actually, a shit ton better. Indeed, one of the most memorable scenes in film this year involves Hayden Christensen's David and Jamie Bell's fellow jumper Griffin fighting over a series of landscapes that include the pyramids, the Empire State Building, and a bustling freeway. It's so cool you could shove it into a blitzer with tequila, triple sec and fresh lime, and make frozen margaritas. Which reminds me of a joke. Why did the Mexican throw his wife off the roof? Tequila! But here's the thing. While the jumping sequences are sexier than a busload of inebriated cheerleaders on the way to the Saint-Tropez nudist beach, they overshadow the plot, which, to be honest, is somewhat thin. David's character is a little two-dimensional, and I never really bought the motivation behind the baddie, played by Samuel L. Jackson. What you end up with is a live-action version of Ben and Jerry on speed. Fun to watch, but not really satisfying. 3 stars. And finally, it's time for Biggie Biggie Snack Snacks. And on the menu today are Werther's Original traditional chewy toffees. Now, the Werther's Originals that I know have made famous in the advertising campaign featuring a grandfather and his grandson. They're more of a hard toffee. This promises some chew, which I'm very excited about. So let's have a crack at it. Little nugget of love here. I've got a good chew. And one of the problems I have with toffee is sometimes it feels like it's going to rip my teeth out. And this doesn't feel too bad. It's got a good, rich flavour. That's because it's made out of real butter and fresh cream. It's going to go straight onto my cheeks. But do you not? I don't mind. This is a classic, homely, welcoming, almost maternal taste. And I love my mother. So I'm going to give this 4 stars.